Hey everyone, Howard Pinsky here, showing you guys how to create an iOS style icon in Photoshop. Today we're going to be creating the new Photos icon that's part of the iOS 7 beta. Now while I don't find this icon particularly attractive, I think you guys are going to pick up some nice tips and tricks along the way. Let's get to it. Starting off with the document, I like to start large, but not too large. 1024 by 1024 pixels will work well. And then once the document has been created, I'm going to fill the background with a nice light blue, just so we have a bit of contrast against the white icon. Now we can go ahead and create the shape of the icon, which will be slightly different depending on the size of your starting document. As the corners of the icon are rounded, the rounded rectangle tool will do the trick. When starting off with a 1024 by 1024 pixel document, a radius of 220 pixels will give us the corners that we're looking for. But like I mentioned, if your document is larger or smaller, you're going to have to adjust the radius. Now you can drag out the icon from the top left of your document down to the bottom right, making sure to hold down your shift key in order to maintain a square aspect ratio. And after you've created your shape, if the color is not set to white, you can double click on the shape layer's thumbnail in the layers panel and set the color accordingly. Next, to help us position the colored petals, we're going to be placing guides in the centers of our icon. If you don't see the rulers on the left and top of your workspace, Command or Control R will reveal them. Now you can drag out a horizontal and vertical guide, which should snap to the centers of your icon. Now we can start creating the colored petals in the middle. With the rounded rectangle tool still active, drag out the first petal towards the top of the icon, making sure to leave a little bit of breathing room. Once your shape has been created, place it in the center of the icon, right on top of the horizontal guide, and then move it up 30 pixels by holding down your shift key and pressing the up arrow 3 times. As for the color of this shape, it's going to be a nice bright orange. The value I'm going to be using will be FAA733. Now we get to the fun process of duplicating. Command or Control J will quickly duplicate your current layer, and then Command or Control T will enter free transform mode. Here's where you need to pay attention. We want the shape to rotate around the center of the icon. So grab the pivot point from the center of your current shape and drag it to the center of the icon where the two guides meet. Now when you rotate your shape, it pivots around that center point. But instead of guessing where you want to drop it, hold down your shift key before rotating. This will rotate in increments of 15 degrees. Once it snaps 3 times or at 45 degrees, you can accept the rotation by pressing return or enter. The color for the second shape is going to be F26967. Now, thankfully, the process from here is a little bit easier. Because we've already defined a transformation, we can tell Photoshop to use the same conditions as we did before. Once again, duplicate this shape with Command or Control J, but instead of manually rotating again, we can use the Transform Again feature, which is located under the Edit, Transform Path menu. If all goes well, Photoshop should rotate that new duplicate 45 degrees around the center of your document. For this shape, the color is going to be set to D486AD. Again, duplicate with Command or Control J, Edit, Transform Path, again. This shape's color is going to be A38EC3. Duplicate, transform again, and the color will be a light blue, 79ABDB. Again, duplicate, transform again, and the color this time is going to be 6CC198. Command or Control J to duplicate, transform again. We're almost there. This color is going to be B3D557. Now one last time, duplicate with Command or Control J, transform again, and finally this color is going to be F8E32B. Alright, we're past the repetitive nonsense. Now obviously the petals in the Photos icon has a bit of transparency to them. You can achieve this effect by setting the blend mode of those layers to multiply. So, in your Layers panel on the right, select the top petal, and then with your Shift key held down, select the bottom petal. Once they've all been selected, set the blend mode to multiply, and you should see the petals overlap quite nicely, leaving you with the final result. Again, this wouldn't be my choice of design for this icon, but I felt you guys may pick up some good tips while recreating this design. If you want to check out the written version of this tutorial, or you'd like to download the PSD for this design, check out ICEFLOWSTUDIOS.com. Hey guys, and thanks for watching that tutorial. I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you want to help keep my content free for as long as possible and you want to help support what I do, check out patreon.com/HowardPinsky. Patreon allows people like yourself to tip content creators like me for every video that I release. And even a $1 tip for every video is going to help keep my content free and help support my business. So check out patreon.com/HowardPinsky, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Take care.